Hi guys, so in one of our earlier episodes we spoke with regards to what we do with all the strawberries. You saw how many we picked that particular day. A few people have asked us over the last sort of couple of weeks, you know, why have we got so many strawberry plants, what do we do with the strawberries, this, that and the other. Now we freeze some for things like shakes or to have with cereal and things like that. And we also make strawberry leathers, and that's what I'm going to show you today. Okay guys, I'm going to stand to the side and not going to try and get in your way. As you can see in the background here, we've got quite a few bowls of strawberries. This one is a big mixing bowl. We've got absolute kilo after kilo after kilo of strawberries here. They've all been at the tops cut off them, they've been washed and what have you, and they're now ready. Now the great thing about this this whole recipe is the fact that it only really contains two ingredients. That's the strawberries and a little bit of sweetener. Now you can use sugar, in this case I'm going to use castor, and also you could also use honey as well. So it's a case of just getting some of the strawberries and putting them into the blender, and you can weigh it by cup or by millilitres or by ounces or whatever you want to do, but I never ever bother with that guys. I just fill this up, and these are quite sweet because they're very thin, so you don't need a lot of sugar, and I'm talking just a little bit of sugar, don't need a lot, maybe a teaspoon, 2 teaspoons for this. Sorry, 2 tablespoons for this. It's not even that, it's probably 1 tablespoon in here, okay? And you'll have to excuse my dog eating in her bowl. Unfortunately, there's not a lot I can do about him doing this in the house. And it's just a case of blending it. Now, this might get a little loud, all right, and I'll maybe edit it out. But you want to blend this now. If you need to, you can add a touch of water, but bear in mind, if you add any water, you've got to dehydrate that out later, so the less you can add, the better. One thing that might help is if I actually plug it in. Bear with me 1 second. Okay, let's try this again. It's not one of them days to me, guys. Just gonna switch that off a second and see if I can find. Now, a decent cook would have everything to hand. There's a few little lumps in here, I just want to move them off the side because obviously we want to get as little lump as possible in it. Okay guys, and that is it. I'm going to see if I can show you it. So I'm going to come behind just so I can see what I'm showing you. So that's it guys. It's just a very liquidy puree. Okay, I'm going to pour this now into a jug. You'll have to excuse me because of the angle on the kitchen, it's a bit awkward. So as you can see, we've just basically very small amount of sugar. I'm going to do another one now because obviously we need more, but it's just a very small amount of sugar and the rest of it is fruit. This can be made, it's called a strawberry leather. It can be made with pretty much any fruit. It can be made with bananas, blueberries, any berry. It's a great way of giving kids fruit during the colder months. Like I said, just a little bit of sugar just to sweeten it. These are quite sweet, so I don't put a lot in. So obviously we don't want to be filling our kids up with with sugars and stuff. So I'm going to cut you, even though I'm going to do this next one, and then I'll come back to you then for the next bit. Alright guys? Okay guys, so again, excuse me, we have our strawberry puree, and here we have a baking tray, okay, quite a large baking tray, and inside it put a piece of grease proof paper, okay, and the idea is now is to put some of this in, and we might not use it all in one go, on the baking tray, and we need to spread it out, and you want this quite thin, but if you can see the bottom is too thin, okay, and you'll need to and you might be surprised just how much of this you'll actually get to use out of this jug, okay. Now it won't finish up this colour, and as you remember we used that whole bowl to make up these two. There we go. Okay, try and get it as level as possible. And there we go. I think now we're ready for the next step. Okay, give it a little shake if you want to, just to level it up. But now we're ready for the next step, guys. Okay? That's nice. So, the next step now is to put it in the oven. Okay? 170 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, guys. So, this is more or less ready to come out. I got a confession to make. I had to pour it all back into the jug and redo it, and the reason for that was because, like a donkey, I put the parchment paper upside down and it would have stuck, so just remember, make sure you get your parchment paper the right way. This is more or less done now, so as you can see, you want to leave it now till it gets dry, you know, to the touch. There's still a little bit of give in it, but that's ready to come out. So we can turn the oven off. And the other thing as well, I'm just going to alter you a second. The other thing as well, guys, was this is a new oven compared to last time I done it. And the temperatures varied in it. And we had to basically put this one down as low as we could, okay. So this is literally it. So peel off the pan, and that's what you're looking for, okay. Now we need to leave this to cool down. Just move that towel out the way. And I'm not jerking you about you, but basically, now once this cools, you'll be able to peel it off the parchment paper. But first off, all you do is cut it into strips, okay. So you turn it that way, and you would just cut it into strips. And it can be rolled up, and then the kids can just peel it off here and chew it. And this works, you know, really well. And all it tastes of is strawberries. I had one little bit here that caused a little bit of a burn, but it's no problem if it comes, so we can cut that out. So, for those of you who don't know, guys, that strawberry leather.